Hey guys, today I'm playing some more City Skylines Mass Transit and everything's going well. What did that person just say about me? The mayor has worked tirelessly and now the regional government has passed a bill that allows for larger city territory. Hashtag annex. No way, really. Nope, that's just simply not true. Maybe it's because I have the mod. But yeah, apparently I can have more land. I don't know what that tweet was about. When I also came up, I also got this, this notification again, which is pretty weird. I guess maybe because I'm on 180,000, it thinks I passed 80,000 again? I don't know what kind of math is going on there. What kind of maths is going on there? But, alright. Anyway, yes, yeah, so we're back. We're playing. We're doing shit. Well, we're doing well. We're doing shit as in things, not shit as in poorly. We're quite the city. And I'm turning Rome Beach into an office district. Because I need offices, because there is an endless demand for industry. Which I shouldn't complain about, because for like 4 episodes there was no demand for anything and they were really boring. But then this series did take on its final form as just podcasts, so can't complain too much. This person's dying. Don't know what to tell you, buddy. That's just gonna happen when you live next to an incinerator. It's no good, man. Yeah. Ugh, man, I gotta move. I live in a really polluted part of London. It's like one of the most polluted bits. It's like, oh my god, because it's right on a main road, so it's not great. One day all the things I say about where I'm gonna live are gonna make it really easy to find out where I live, which is not great. Anyway, alright, let's just keep on expanding and stuff. I need more shops, but I'm, yeah. Maybe more hotels, actually. I don't think I have a lot of hotels. I know I have some hotels. Where are my hotels? Because I've got, like, leisure and stuff. Where are my districts? So that's leisure. That's leisure. That's... okay. Where are my hotels? I swear I had some. I mean, there's some here. There's a few hotels there. Do I only have one hotel district? Oh no, we've got a few there. But yeah, we're pretty short on hotels, actually. Maybe that's why my tourism isn't great. I could put them around here, back of the city. This could be the cheap hotels where you can overlook industry. Yeah, alright. Let's do that. So I'm gonna have kind of a block of hotels, I think, like this. So, yeah, that'll be good. Because we don't really need tons of shops. What we do need is a place. I swear I put some over here. Maybe I accidentally deleted them, or never did it, and just thought I did. Yeah, that happens sometimes. Alright, okay. Let's get this all hoteled out, so we can get more tourists in here, more money, more everything. Because that's what we need. We need more money for more launch sites, because I reduced taxes a while ago, and I'm a little reticent to put them back up. So, little hesitant? Yeah, I'm gonna get... anyway. Oh, I also have some hotels over here. Yeah, yeah, on my little party island. alright. So yeah, let's go hotels, bro. Yeah, district is there. Okay. Man, it would be really good if you left that district marker up so I knew where I was putting stuff. Ooh, guy talking over me. We'll have none of that. We'll have none of that, Mars Radio man. This is my show. This is talking over me, you son of a bitch. So yeah, okay. It's pretty much to like here, I guess. So just go crazy. Just go crazy with hotels. Alright. Talking of similar things to hotels, I read a really nice story on BBC the other day. yes, it's actually an uplifting topic, which is rare for this series, but whatever. But basically this there was this kid who would always go on cruises with his parents. I guess they went on like 4 or 5 cruises on Carnival Cruises, an American cruise company. So when he was on one of them, he was like, I want to share this with my friends. So he created a Snapchat account called Carnival Cruises to show off his sick Carnival Cruise. And that was fun and all, but eventually Carnival Cruises wanted that Snapchat handle. So they contacted him. They actually went to his house and were like, hey, we'll give you a free cruise if we can have that handle. So they got like a free cruise to Spain. It's like $5,000. His whole family gets to go. They surprise him on the thing. And I was like, oh, that's so nice. I love it when companies do fun stuff like that. Like, I get that it's all just marketing, but it's really, it's nice, you know? Like, so yeah. this kid just had it over his Snapchat handle and got like a free $5,000 like cruising holiday. And I was like, that's the perfect way of handling it. They didn't like, you know, try and legal him or try and pay him. They were just like, yeah, fuck it, you like cruises, have a cruise. So that was nice. It was just one of the, yeah, so much depressing stuff in the world these days. I really like seeing just like nice stories like that. They just make me happy. You know, it's like, oh, the world isn't all terrible. Sometimes corporate interests align with our interests. All right, let's start taxing industry a little bit more. I need that percent point. I actually don't need any money. I have 15 million. It would take a long time to exhaust that. How's the rocket coming? Pretty good. I want to have a second launch site. I reckon it'd be good for visitors. I also think I need another airport. How many does this service... Oh, 64. Okay, probably not then. How many does this service... 61, eh? Not bad, not bad, not bad at all. Yeah, we got people coming in. So, 26 passengers on there. 10 are leaving, okay. How many people are coming into West Poor People Town Airport? 200? This is servicing way more than 64 then. Like, there's like 200 people on that plane. Jesus, fuck you, it's 64 a week. Yeah, and it's pretty, like, jammed up. I'm thinking I'd need another airport. I don't know where I'd put it, though. I mean, this is all a bit too clogged. We've got our international airport over there. I guess you could go land in the oil fields. That would busy up that road even more than it needs to be. Yeah, I don't really know. I don't want to put it over here because there's already an airport there and a launch site. Got a bunch of empty land here I guess I could use, but it's too far from anything. Maybe just like here. Yeah, if I bridged over here, like I tried to build a bridge here last time, but it kind of just looked like shit. I could probably do a better one. It'd be fine. Alright, so yeah, I want another airport. That's my project for today. Yeah, okay. Well, maybe if I just put a bridge in, like... There we go. Bridge. And then connect this road to that road. Let's go like that. Can I do this? Not quite. Oh. I don't want to busy up that track. It'll be... No, it might not be fine, though. Okay. Well, is there any way I can get a road over there? No? Okay. Alright, we'll figure this out. I'm going to move this train track a little bit. I can just move it a bit. Put the... Actually, I could probably just bridge the train track. Okay, that's what I'm going to do. Right, move the train back. Put this here. Link up there. Link up, son of a bitch! Alright. There we go. Oh no, that looks like shit now. Ah, everything's fucked. Everything's ruined. My life is over. I'm just going to quit. I'm just going to go. I'm done. Alright. And we're good. Fuck you! Fuck you! Space already occupied. Oh, this is slightly more complicated than I thought it would be. There we go. There we go. There we fucking go. Alright, bring this road back. God, it's a hassle. I don't know how anyone ever builds, like, a really nice looking city. Because it would just take... It would take years. I guess some people have time. Like, I currently have no time. But that's not true. It's like, that's not the reason I don't build nice looking stuff in city skylines. It's not... a lack of time. It's a lack of caring. I have a very limited attention span. For some things, obviously, like work is fine, but for building a road that looks nice, it's like, okay, well, in like 2 seconds, I'm not gonna care. So, you know, I'm not gonna put much effort into this, which is probably not great for someone who creates content online. Can you just link the fuck up? Can you stop being a huge bitch your whole life? Maybe if I did... Yeah, maybe if I, like, curved it a bit. Had a bit of a curve... Like, if it spiraled down a little bit. Okay. But if you weren't a bitch your whole life. Okay. And then just, like, a really tight breakneck turn. There we go. That looks good. I might actually just bring it around. Yeah, that looks dumb as shit. All right. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, that'll work. Maybe. Probably not. Oh, fuck you. Oh, you're such a hassle. This game is a hassle. I should stop playing games that are like work. Like, so, you know, when I'm done working for the day and it's like 9, because I'm doing a lot. Like, I do YouTube and then dissertation and then look for jobs. So I stop at like 9 and then I call my girlfriend at 10. So I have about an hour where I just play games. And right now I'm playing Hearts of Iron. And that's a really bad choice because Hearts of Iron is work. It is winning a war. It is not easy to win a war. I've been coming out of it recently just more drained than after like 5 hours of programming. Just like trying to defeat whomever I'm trying to defeat. It's like, this is serious stuff. And yeah. And like all my favorite games are like that. Like Prison Architect, City Skylines, although I don't play this in my spare time because I, well, play it for the series. And then RimWorld as well. That is work. And yeah, all the games I've always found most addicting are always just kind of like work simulators. I think it's true of a lot of people. I think a lot of people just kind of like that kind of thing. And I'm one of them. But it is kind of, you know, just... I don't know what my point was, but something about, you know, a game's feeling like work. Like, I even spend time when I'm not playing Hearts of Iron thinking about how I'm gonna win Hearts of Iron. It's like, okay, well, I mean, I clearly don't have enough tanks for this. It's like, dude, stop working on game. Anyway, alright, yeah, this is a good place for an airport. I don't like it by the side of the road, though. I don't know what it is, but just putting, like, an airport by the side of a random road is just shitty to me. Like, this one's at least kind of tucked in somewhere. Oh, I'm gonna turn this back on. That guy stopped talking. Alright, cool. You know what? I'm gonna do a little ring with some trees so it looks nice when people get here. So they're like, oh, this is a nice city. And then they drive through poor people town. And they're like, oh, roll up the windows. Maybe something like that? Maybe I'll make it look nicer, although probably not. Yeah, that could work. Yeah, I kind of like that. A shitty place to land a plane. Like, train tracks either side. But, oh, it also needs power. Yeah, I actually kind of hate... That's going to... I kind of hate it being like that now. Because, yeah. You can't have train tracks either side. That's the dumbest thing anyone's ever done. I guess I could have tunnels or something, but nah. Alright. Maybe they should make a runway that's a tunnel. Yeah, that'd be smart move. That'd be great. That'd be such a challenge for the pilots. It'd be like, well, you gotta land in the tunnel. That'll be fun. Ooh, I've just come up with a new extreme sport. Crashing planes in tunnels. I kinda want it to look sort of quirky, but no, fuck it. I'm just gonna build like a protruding square. I can just leave the game running. Let my money build up. Yeah. I don't know why I'm so unhappy. Maybe if it was just like this. Yeah. I'm very particular about some things in this game, but not others. Okay. And then just move this here. And yeah, it's going to be within the train lines, but not quite as close. You know what? Yeah, I quite like that, actually. They're kind of square. It's going to need some power. So let's put some nice big power lines next to it for the planes to miss. Or not, as the case may be. And it's going to need water. I love how janky my water system is. Everything I do is janky. It's great. It's just kind of my, it's kind of what happens. You know, I figured out my personality type the other day, and not the whole kind of IGL Q9-11. Why is the number I always think of following 9-11? Yeah, you know, the whole IGL Q thing that's like, well, I've forgotten what my one is for that. My personality type actually is like logician or something, because, you know, that's like no surprise. But, because I'm so smart. No, but I figured out what my personality type in like an RPG is, and it is idiot savant. I am totally an idiot savant. I'm not like someone who plans and does things really well. I just kind of, things just sort of happen around me, and it always just sort of works out. And I think that's a good way to be, you know? I think idiot savantism is like the best personality to be in an RPG, because it's like, you don't have to try that hard. Things just sort of happen and it's great. And seriously, I think that's how my whole life goes, and I think it's great. I don't plan things, you know. Planning isn't really my forte. Like, I would kind of wish I planned things more, but I feel like people who plan things a lot wish they were more spontaneous, so I don't think there's any way people are happy about who they are. Ooh, getting dark again. No, but I'm totally an idiot savant. Like, it's very obvious in my playing of video games. I guess because I play mostly kind of strategy games and things, it doesn't come across, but in like first-person shooters, like Penguin and I were playing some Left 4 Dead 2 last night, and I kept just like, just crazy shit would keep happening to me, and I would just randomly survive. Like, I almost fell down this hole and lost the whole mission, but the guy pulling me got killed just in time. Not by me, I wasn't doing anything to help, but it just sort of worked out. And then, you know, I would just stupid stuff would keep happening to me, but I would keep just sort of surviving. Like, there was this ladder I kept walking up, and there were like four of the the weird guys at the top, the tougher zombies who jump on your head or jump on you and stuff. And I walked up this ladder three times, and every time one of them just tackled me to the ground. And it was just a kind of bumbling idiot sort of thing. I think an idiot savant would kind of come across as. But it always sort of worked out. And the same is true of my life. It is not just in video games, but I think video games provide a good example because, you know, they let you do exciting things. But no, in my life, I kind of have just about sort of gotten through. Like, this started not super long ago. Like, when I was a kid, I was smart enough to just sort of win school. Like, I didn't try that hard in my GCSEs, but I got like a bunch of A stars and A's and B's and a D, because I'm not very good at music. And actually no C's, I tell a lie. What happened here? I've disconnected the power somehow. I think this might be another one of those how did this ever work moments. Okay, alright, I guess. Oh, this got a bit deleted? Don't know how that happened, but okay. That was not great. But then I got to A-level. A-level's hard. Like, I think there are a few people who find A-level something they can do just on being kind of smart. So, I kind of basically sort of just failed my way through the first year and most of the second year. And then it came time to apply for universities. And it was like, well, I need to say that I'm going to get good grades, but I don't think my teachers would agree with that. So, like, you know, I think I was predicted 3 C's, which I beat. And I was like, well, I want to apply for some good universities, like some really good ones, which was kind of a dumb move. So I need it to at least be like, you know, an A and 2 B's, but there's no way to make them do that. But I managed to convince my one of my maths teachers, who I was doing well on the module, but not the whole thing. And I was like, well, I reckon I can get a B, sir. And he's like, okay, well, if you think that's true, I think that's true. It looks like it from this, which I was quite good at, but all the other modules, because in maths, in A-level, you do a bunch of different modules, and one of them I was good at. I don't really remember. But anyway, so I convinced that guy. I convinced my computing teacher to say I would get an A, because, I don't know, maybe he wasn't very smart and didn't know who I was. Which is weird, because I'm good at computing, but I was just bad at A-levels. And then my physics teacher would just not budge on it. They were like, no, you're getting a C, I don't think you're going to get a B or whatever. And I was like, all right, bitch, well, you know, fine. So I had some all right grades, and then my tutor comes up to me and was like, didn't you want an A and 2 B's for your predicteds? And I was like, yeah, but the physics person wouldn't give it to me. And he was like, well, I actually have final say over this, so I can just change it. I was like, okay. So just kind of walked ass backwards into that, got all the offers I wanted, like King's, who did I apply to? Like King's, Queen's, Essex, Reading? No. I don't know, I applied to a bunch and I got them all, and then, like, most of them didn't even require an interview, and the one that did require an interview, which I believe was at Essex, it was like, come to interview, and I was like, nah, I'm good. I'm not going to do that. So I just didn't go to the interview, and they gave me the offer anyway, because apparently I must have looked like a really good student. So yeah, I just kind of got that offer, just sort of randomly. And then, yeah, basically what happened was I didn't get those predicted grades, because it turns out when teachers predict you grades, they sort of know what they're talking about. And so I didn't get them. I got a B and two C's at A-level, which is fine, but it's not very good. It's not like, you know, really good. So all the universities I'd applied for obviously turned me down, because I'd taken King's and Queen Mary's as my choices. And they were like, no, you fucked up. Those aren't the grades we asked for. You can't come here. So then I had to apply through clearing, got into my current university, which I'm not going to say what it is, because it's, you know, it's would be privacy, you know? Anyway, so I managed to talk my way into that. Like, I basically just had to get on the phone and be like, yeah, no, I fucked up, but I'm really good at this shit. You know, you're going to want me. And actually, funnily enough, I also got an offer in clearing through Essex, didn't go there. So they offered it to me twice, and I turned them down both times. So, yeah. Anyway, so I think that's fairly savanty. Like, I just sort of talked my way into university, pretty much. And then, and then it was like, ooh. And when I was a little younger, it was like, ooh, should probably get a job. My mom was like, get a job, because, you know, you're going to have to do stuff over the summer and you need money. And then YouTube happened. I was like, yeah, no, I can just play video games for a job. Which is, like, just fucking stupid. Like, yeah. Anyway, my point is I never have to try at anything. It always just works out. Like, first year when I was looking for roommates, I had, like, one guy who wasn't... It was basically, there was, like, me and this other guy who were going to live together. But you need more than two people in a student house. And all my other friends already had houses. And then it was, like, the last month, and I was like, shit, we gotta get a place. And then it just turned out my other roommates, who I didn't know that well, who I still live with, actually, now, were like, oh, yeah, our people dropped out as well, so there's only two of us. So then the four of us lived together, and it was like, wow, that just worked out. Yeah, so I've started formulating the theory that I never have to try at anything. I just, things just work for me. Oh, anyway, yeah. Sorry, that was a really long ramble about kind of nothing. I hope that wasn't really boring. It was my life story. If that's boring to you, then that's fine, because I'm 21. Nothing has happened to me. I don't know, I've had interesting... Well, no, your parents have had interesting lives, and you were just there for bits of it. Yeah. Okay, this is cool. It's kind of like it's through a park. I like this. I like this a lot. Yeah, and there's probably a few other things, but now I'm applying for jobs and it's gotten a bit... It's going a bit savanty again, you know? It's not... yeah. Although I did point out a security flaw on one of my applications to a job, and they've just given me a online interview, so... Looking pretty good. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I like this. It's kind of like a park. I don't like these, though. These look like shit. I'm gonna remove these parks. I might put a park in. It actually kind of looks like it's trees, maybe? Maybe put some footpaths in, make a custom park, it'll be good. Just, it'll look kind of nice, I guess, I don't know. But yeah, that is my theory about, like, my RPG character type is just, you know, just idiot savant. Just stuff sort of happens around me and it sort of works out. And it's all sort of good. everything's good. Yeah, it's looking kind of cool. I'm liking this. I'm liking this a lot. There we go. Yeah, that's just, yeah. That's looking good. It's the shitty airport with the shitty park, but hey, it's better than no park. Alright. Need more shops. Put some more in the burbs. Nah, I'm gonna put more houses in the burbs. Whew. Ooh, shit. Alright. There we go. It's looking good. Oh, follow up to the Facebook thing, I guess. Facebook's had a bad week. Like, I talked about the Cambridge Analytica thing last time, and that was like, ooh, Facebook, you gotta be careful with that shit, man. Like, they're just, you're doing whatever. But then it turned out that Facebook was also, like, storing loads of data they shouldn't be storing on people. So someone downloaded their Facebook data and was like, oh, I wonder what's in here. And then I had a list of all their phone calls. Like, not their Facebook phone calls, just their phone calls. And it was like, okay. So that was like an exploit in an older... Someone's talking over me again. So that was an exploit in an older version of Android. Basically, they did some stuff so that they could like look at your phone calls. So that was pretty bad. I checked mine, there's no phone calls in mine. Because the other thing is a lot of people, basically you can connect your phone to Facebook. I've never done this with anything except maybe Twitter. But basically, yeah, people were like, so it's really fucked up that they were logging your phone calls. However, their response was pretty shitty. Like, they didn't... I don't think people realized that they had given access to their phone when they gave permissions to their phone. It's like, I know when it first came about, it was, you know, maybe 5 years ago where it just asked for your phone number. And I think that's where it started. I never even gave it my phone number because I really didn't want my phone number to be on Facebook because that's really stupid to have your phone number on Facebook. When I downloaded my Facebook data, there was no phone call things because I've never linked my phone to my Facebook. I have the Facebook app on my phone and it is an Android phone, so it would be vulnerable to this, but like, I was just like, why would I link my phone to it? No, I don't need two-factor authentication because I don't care. I don't know. I probably should have two-factor authentication, but I'm not doing that now. I'm not on Facebook anywhere near my phone. Not after this. But it's been such a bad week. So there was all of that where it turned out they've been storing a bunch of, you know, bunch of phone call data, which even if you gave them access to your phone, it's fucking weird that they were storing it. Like, the point was that they would look at your contacts, not track your calls. Like, all of them. So maybe check yours just to see if that's happened. Unless you have an Apple phone, then you're fine. Seriously, just buy an iPhone. Like, it's so much more secure in, like, every way. Not a big fan of Apple, but they make the better phones. So the other Facebook thing was, like, today it came out that there was a memo from one of their chief guys. I've forgotten his actual role, but he was, like, a top guy. top men. But anyway, the memo basically said anything that is good for the growth of Facebook as a business is justifiable, pretty much. Anything is justifiable, including deaths from cyberbullying and terrorism. So it seemed like this guy believed that Facebook was so important that it was more important than people being alive. And like, it's a business, but this was said by one guy. So it just seems to never stop for Facebook, which is good, because fuck Facebook. The problem with Facebook, though, is on my last thing when I was talking about all the stuff they were doing, one guy aptly pointed out, why don't you just not have Facebook? And it's like, yes, it sounds extremely like, well, just delete your Facebook. There's no problem there. However, it's how I communicate with people. I use Messenger, and I know you don't actually need a Facebook account for Messenger, but what I would have to do is go through, like, everyone, and be like, hey, I've changed my name or something, or add everyone again. And it will be fine for, like, my close friends who I talk to a lot, but the thing is there's people I haven't seen in years who occasionally message me, and then I'd probably lose that. It's not that easy to delete your Facebook account. They've made it too useful. It's annoying, And I hate that I can't delete my Facebook account because it's how I communicate with people. It's not how I would choose to communicate with people, by the way. I hate messaging people. It is the worst form of communication. But it is, as is the world, it is not actually my choice. So bad time for Facebook. Really bad time. I did download that data, and it did have a log of all my messages. I saw some people surprised that it was logging your Facebook messages, and it was like, yeah, because Facebook, obviously it's gonna log everything you do on Facebook. That's not creepy. The creepy part's the phone call bit. Anyway, I'm not gonna stay too long on Facebook. I don't want this to become the Facebook podcast. Yeah. Oh, and now Mark Zuckerberg has to go to court and pretend to be a human. He's so funny. He's so bad at being a human. Oh, it's a shame as well, because my inspiration to start getting into computing was The Social Network, the movie. And like, so obviously it was inspired, my whole thing is like inspired by the whole Facebook thing. I was like, oh yeah, how the fuck do you make a website? So I started looking into that, started learning HTML, CSS, and then eventually, you know, PHP and Python and then Java and then C++, and now I'm here. So I kind of owe my, like, it's, I was more inspired by the film than Mark Zuckerberg himself. Like, I really liked the film. And actually, I think largely, in a way, I was largely inspired by Eduardo Saverin, because he was, so, you know, so good at business, although I've lost a lot of interest in business and money. So, yeah, that's not a big thing anymore. But yeah, no, it's a shame. It was a very influential film in my life, and I still watch the film a lot because, you know, Jesse Eisenberg's great. But it's just a shame that it's about Facebook, you know, because Facebook's the fucking worst. Yeah, well, anyway, I will actually cease to talk about Facebook because, you know, no, this will not become the Facebook podcast. I'm going to clean out these trees a bit. How's our rocket coming? We got another rocket? Almost, actually. Almost. We'll get another launch next time. Anything else happening? Oh, there's that whole big thing about the Nazi joke guy. That's an interesting thing that happened in Britain. I know this is way late, but I record these weekly, so some stuff's gonna be late. But yeah, that guy in Scotland, I think, got charged for making a Nazi joke. Like, that he, you know, you've heard about this already. Like, the whole, guy, the what was his name? Dr. Dankula. Count Dankula. He did the whole Nazi pug thing, and then he got charged for hate speech. It was like, oh, Jesus Christ, that sucks. Like, so, the American reaction was extremely strong, because in America you have this constitution which affords you the right to total free speech, but other countries don't have that so much, especially Britain. Not especially Britain. Britain has relatively free speech, but it does have anti-hate speech laws, much like Canada does. Although I think Canada has some compelled speech laws. Compelled speech laws now. I believe it might actually be illegal to not call someone by their desired pronoun, which is pretty heavy fucking handed. Like, I would always try to call someone by their desired pronoun, but I'm not gonna get fucking charged for not doing so. I'll call you what the fuck I wanna call you. Like, obviously it is horrible to, you know, be called what, you know, the wrong gender or whatever, but I don't think there should be a requirement that people are nice to each other. I think people should try to be nice to each other, but I don't think it should be legally required that people are not insulted. And that's my opinion on, I have complex opinions on hate speech, and I think my opinion isn't as valid as a lot of people's, as I am a white man, and there is nothing you can say to insult. You could call me a cracker, but it would be like, oh, yeah, remember when I had all the money and land? I'm joking, but you know, my point is that my perspective on this is limited, as I've never been subject to hate speech, really. So, yeah, but my opinion on it, as I think a lot of people's is this is dumb as fuck. That he's been charged for dressing up a pug, and yeah, he sort of, I can see how maybe it was like, oh, he said something about gas the Jews, but clearly in the, what the fuck is happening here? My power lines are disappearing. What is happening? I must be accidentally clicking on something. Okay, I'm gonna, yeah. And yeah, so he, the joke obviously just wasn't very funny, and yes, some of the words he used in it were reprehensible, but it was a joke, and the premise of the joke was that Nazis are bad. So, yeah, so I think the ruling is ridiculous, and also while I do think anti-hate speech laws do serve a purpose, and I think that in Britain, largely, they're not overbearing, and I don't know how I feel about them exactly, but I don't know how I feel about free speech, you know? It's one of those things that like many big world problems, it's one of the things I do not have a concrete opinion on. It's like gun control. I don't have a lot of people seem to, you know, well, this is the solution. It's like, I don't think any of them are, but at the same time, I live in Britain, so it doesn't affect me. So free speech is complicated, right? Because, you know, both sides have trouble. So you can have totally free speech and, you know, no one can compel you to say or not say anything, which is good because you are free. However, does allow for people to say some pretty terrible things to people. It does allow for people to be openly and extremely racist. It allows for Nazi groups to form freely, just extremist groups. I shouldn't single out the Nazis, but I don't care what happens to Nazis, so I'll single them out all I want. But obviously free speech, yeah, gives rise to that kind of thing, extremist groups and, you know, Nazis and all of that. So that's the problem is, you know, bad people can say what they want, but the flip side is on the other side of it, of you know, things like anti-hate speech laws and especially compelled speech kind of move sort of towards, if you're not careful, I guess it could become an authoritarian thing. Now, the argument that a lot of people use, which is totally invalid, is, if you're going to make this law about not saying this word, then where does it stop? And the answer to that is it stops somewhere. Just because one thing happens doesn't mean the slightly worse, more extreme thing is going to happen. Like, it stops somewhere. But it is limiting of freedom, and I also don't think it would very effectively actually combat things like racism. I think people who are racist are going to be racist, and telling them that, you know, what they're doing is illegal isn't going to make them think, oh, okay, now I like black people, or whomever. I don't think it's effective at combating the core issue, and I feel like limiting people's freedoms is sort of, it's a dicey situation, and I mean, the worst left-wing or dictatorships, which aren't much different from right-wing dictatorships in the end, like the Soviet Union and Nazi Germany, weren't that different, really. Like, there were a lot of things you couldn't say, you couldn't speak out against your leader, you know, you had to say Heil Hitler or whatever, and so it's a complicated issue, and there's a cost for everything, basically. Nothing is free, you know? You can have free speech and allow for hateful speech, or you can have limited speech and have limited freedom of speech, which is, it's complicated. I don't know. It's, yeah. But anyway, no, the thing about the Count Dankula thing is, I don't think he should be convicted for that. That was stupid as fuck. Like, if it had been a massively racist video where he'd actually been, if it said, I turned the dog into the least cute thing I could think of, a Jew, then, okay, right, that's different. But he said, the least cute thing I can think of, a Nazi. Yeah, it was stupid. It's a stupid conviction, and I hope it gets overturned. And it is, I don't know, I think I lean generally more on the side of free speech than limited speech. Although that is coming from the perspective of someone who has never been subject to hate speech. So, yeah. Anyway, this is one of the subjects where I'm just gonna talk myself in circles if I do for too long. So, sometimes I just spill my mind and figure things out in real time. And I don't know if that makes good content, but, I don't know, people seem to like when I talk about things. But maybe I should prepare them a little more. I don't know, maybe it's interesting to hear me sort of work out my opinions on things. I don't know. But anyway, I think I'm gonna call it here. Good video. New airport, new everything. Covered that I am an idiot savant. Which I like. That's the kind of person I want to be. Just, you know, walks ass backwards into things. Things just work out. Everything's great, and it's rarely by my doing. and then, you know, yeah, talk about free speech, jobs, I guess. I don't know. Anyway. Oh, and the carnival boat guy. That was great. The carnival cruises. I want a free cruise. Anyway, yeah, so, like I said, I hope you've enjoyed this. This has been episode, I don't know even anymore, of City Skylines Mass Transit. I'll see you next time.